think it's ever safe to be around radiation. Like, even a little bit can make you sick, like throwing up and stuff.
I don't know. Any kind of radiation is dangerous. That's why they took those machines out of the airports, the ones that can scan through your clothes. It was too much radiation for people to be around. It could have made someone sick.
I think you'd have to have something protecting you. Like, what's the thing at the doctor's, like the lead thing they put in front of you for an x-ray? But if you didn't have that, I think that it's definitely not safe. Yeah.
Armin, these responses echo sentiments we've heard time and time again. People think even a small amount of radiation will harm them. Is that true?
Well, first we should say that there are a wide range of health effects from radiation, from no effect to death. The health effect depends on the radiation dose, the type of radiation, the length of time we're exposed, your age, and individual sensitivity. Some health effects are acute. They happen right away if we're exposed to a very high level of radiation over a short period of time. That's where we might see nausea, diarrhea, skin damage, possibly seizures and coma. Other radiation effects are much longer term. For example, people who receive low to moderate doses of radiation could have a greater risk of developing cancer later in life.
Is there any safe level? Why do we have such a hard time saying a low-level exposure is safe?
Well, we should add that it's not only radiation protection professionals who have trouble using the word safe. Health and safety professionals in any field are hesitant to say an activity or exposure is safe because, first of all, safety is a matter of perception. It's a subjective characterization and involves personal judgment. A good example is the sport of skydiving. Some people skydive for fun, and statistics show that accidents are very rare. But some people like me are scared of even trying it. Secondly, safe implies zero risk. And zero risk can seldom be guaranteed for anything. It comes back to the ability to be certain that a particular exposure won't cause some health effect many years later.
Like cancer can show up years after an exposure.
Well, let's look at cancer. Because many factors can contribute to a person's cancer risk, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to identify the additional incremental risk presented by low doses of radiation for a given person or group of people. I have a diagram that will help demonstrate this. The baseline cancer risk for a person in the U.S. is about 40%. That means the average person in the U.S. has a 40% chance of developing some type of cancer at some point in his life. Of course, this is just an average, and it could be higher or lower depending on the person's gender, lifestyle, genetic makeup, and environmental factors. Now, let's say someone receives a radiation dose that we estimate increases the cancer risk on average by 1%. Of course, there is variability in that estimate as well. So even though the estimated increased risk is 1%, factoring in the uncertainty could make that higher than 1% or lower than 1%, even zero. Often, for radiation doses that we may encounter, we're talking about estimated additional risks that are even lower than 1%, for example, 0.1%. So while the actual increased cancer risk at these low doses may be very low or even zero, there is uncertainty in our estimation, and radiation professionals are hesitant to be definite about this and use the word safe when these uncertainties exist.
That's really important context to have. When we're talking about an incremental increase in a risk over a long period of time, giving people context and using comparisons can be helpful. It's also important for us to acknowledge the uncertainty. Along with this, we need to show empathy in acknowledging people's fears. Hearing you've been exposed to radiation outside of expected situations can be scary, no matter what the dose or the health effect.